So now that we've reoriented ourselves to basic lung anatomy with the upper lobe, the middle lobe, and the inferior lobe, as shown here, and keep in mind that on the left side of the chest, there's just an upper lobe and a lower lobe, and then a smaller lingula in the middle. Now we're going to talk about the different kinds of things you're actually trying to find when you listen to the lungs. And the first thing I'm going to talk about is just basic breath sounds. And the types of breath sounds that you can auscultate with your stethoscope, again, the diaphragm, are either vesicular, bronchial, or something in the middle, which, you guessed it, is called bronchovesicular. So let's talk about the difference between these kinds of sounds. I encourage you to actually take a listen to yourself, or if you're with somebody else, you guys can listen together, and just start by putting your stethoscope on the lower lung field in the back. And listen and describe what you hear. Take some full deep breaths for me, Sean. Deep breaths through your mouth. So vesicular breath sounds are light, feathery, and you may also note that inhalation is somewhat louder than exhalation. The exhalation, you may hear the beginning of it, but it trails off very quickly. Now I want you to contrast that with a sound that you might hear just lateral to the sternum. And I encourage you to make sure you're listening to the right side of the sternum, because on the left you're of course going to hear the heart, which will confound things. So just listening to the right side of the sternum, either on yourself or again on a friend, take a few more deep breaths. Now it's a subtle distinction, but you'll note that there's the beginning of something that we would call bronchial breath sounds. While you're still hearing that feathery light vesicular breath sounds in the background, you're also now starting to hear something that's a little coarser, a little bit more robust and rougher around the edges. Still, you're hearing more inhalation than exhalation, but there's the beginning of a transition point there. And that's because I'm listening over the main stem bronchi and the large airways of his lungs in the anterior chest. But the next step is we're going to listen to the trachea. So put your stethoscope right over somebody's trachea and the anterior cartilage there. And again, take a few deep breaths through your mouth for me, please, Sean. And again, you can do this on yourself or you can do it with somebody else. And now what we're hearing is very coarse, harsh breath sounds. And you'll note that inhalation and exhalation are essentially identical in volume and pitch. There's also less of a chorus of noise. It really is more of a specific pitch that you're hearing. And this is characteristic of tracheal breath sounds, but it's basically representing, or another way of mimicking, so-called bronchial breath sounds. Now, vesicular breath sounds is normal. You should hear those in all the peripheral lung fields. Bronchovesicular should only be heard here at the areas just lateral to the sternum. But bronchial breath sounds, what we were just hearing over the trachea, is not normal, is abnormal everywhere in the chest. You should not be hearing bronchial breath sounds, because what they represent is essentially the sound of air moving through the upper airways but going directly through some sort of solid tissue to the chest wall where you're listening with your stethoscope without any of those light, feathery, vesicular breath sounds along the way, which tells you that there's something that is preventing air passing through the normal lung parenchyma and producing those light, feathery sounds. And that is typically going to occur with either a cancer, a large mass in the chest, or potentially a socked-in lobar pneumonia, which is just transmitting those vibrations in the large airways all the way through the chest wall to your stethoscope. In addition, you also want to look for adventitious breath sounds. These are the sounds that are in addition to your simply description of the breath sounds themselves. You're looking for things like crackles, rhonchi, and wheezing. Crackles is somewhat of a vague term, but it actually is describing the particular acoustics of what you're hearing. And we typically describe crackles as either fine or dry crackles, or wet, also known as coarse crackles. And fine, dry crackles we associate with interstitial pulmonary fibrosis and things of that nature, that is more of a chronic indolent progression of disease. And they can be really replicated by just pulling pieces of Velcro apart. They're very fine, crisp. There's many different crackles that are occurring within a short span of time, and they have a higher pitch in general. In contrast, wet crackles, so-called because they're oftentimes associated with heart failure, with just a little bit of extra fluid in the alveoli, and they're snapping open when you take a deep breath, those wet crackles are fewer in number, they are a little bit higher in pitch, they're a little bit longer, and you're going to correlate them with how high they go up in the back of the chest. That may give a sense as to how significant somebody's heart failure may be. The next part of adventitious breath sounds is Rhonchi, and Rhonchi essentially are non-specific findings that essentially just suggest that there's some mucus lining the upper airways. They don't have a lot of clinical or diagnostic significance, and oftentimes simply coughing will clear those rancorous breath sounds. Lastly, wheezing. We always think of wheezing associated with asthma and COPD, and wheezing is essentially a chorus of sounds that you're hearing as there's increased turbulent flow through all of those tight airways that we were talking about before that tend to collapse, particularly in the setting of COPD. They should be fairly distributed throughout all lung fields, and you can categorize them as scattered wheezing or diffuse wheezing when you're describing it on the chest.